Place your hand over C, D, E, F, G in the right. And starting with your thumb, play twice. Go up and back down. C, C, D, C. Again, go up and down after two C's. Come up to F now and walk down next door one step. Let's do that all together. Up and down to F and then E. Now we're going to do it again, but we're going to land after the up and down with the thumb. We're going to come up to the pinky and come down to F. G, F. All right, so first it's with the F, E, then it's with the G, F. Always starting with C, C, like this. Go up and down, F. E is next door. Repeat, C, C, up and down, and then G, and next door down. That's the first line of just the right hand. All right, now the left hand needs to be over the F chord, C, F, and A. That is an inverted F chord. Now, it's important that you use these fingers only. Second finger is on F, that index finger, and your thumb is on A. And the reason this is very important is because you need to save your middle finger for when you play C. All right, so I want you to practice this very carefully. Pinky, second finger A on F. Move to C chord now. Pinky, middle finger, all right, like this, C, E, and then the G. All right, play that together. That's a C chord. And now, when you get used to this C chord, do it a couple more times until you're used to it. We're going to have to learn how to switch from C chord with the exact fingers you see here. You were using middle finger on C, now you need that second finger. See the index finger here? You have to press this finger down on F while your thumb comes up to A. So try that. C, F, A. Pinky, index finger, and thumb. C, F, A, inverted F chord. So play your F chord like this. Then get ready for your middle finger while your thumb comes back. You have to move them at the same time. Don't make extra effort by letting your body think it's two separate movements. Now at the same time, move your index finger down and your thumb up. Again, this should be one movement so that your brain is only learning and memorizing one trick. Coming back, it's one movement for the middle finger and the thumb to come home to the C chord. And the only way for you to get automatic at this is to play it over and over so that Happy Birthday will be something you could play even with your eyes closed, because it's your muscles that are memorizing this, not your eyesight. All right, now the song starts with the F chord and then it plays the C chord and then it plays the C chord again. And then it goes back to the F chord. So let's try that. Let's get the right hand where we were, two C's, and then play two hands. Play the C again, go up to F by itself. Now play C chord so it matches the right hand E. Now play two C's again, C, C, and then play C chord again with the right hand D. When you go up to the pinky, get ready for F chord. And right there, F chord matches the right hand F. And that's the end of the second line. We play the F chord and then the C chord twice, not quickly, but in a row after each other when the sentence is correct, and then back to F. That's the whole first line. F chord, wait, C chord, F chord. Now you play happy with two C's, and then you play two hands together. Play the F in the right hand, and then play a C chord with E in the right hand. Now play two C's again, C, C, and then another C chord with the D. Now high G by itself, and then an F chord with the F in the right hand. All right, play two C's now to start off line two and stretch all the way up to the high C. So it's like this. Play C twice, stretch up to the next C. Walk on a backwards F chord, I call this, because the F, A, C, the thumb, middle finger, and pinky, that makes up an F chord right there. But we're just walking down on it. C, A, F. That's an F chord. All right, let's do that again. C, C, high C, the stretch, is coming down the F chord. A, F, crossover with only the second finger to hit E, untuck your thumb and play it next door on D, coming down. We need to do that again. All right, coming down. Birthday, dear, C-A-F, crossover, and uncross to play D with your thumb. All right, now make sure you understand that before you move forward. Okay, let's start on the C, C this time. The beginning of line two, happy two C's. High C, A, F, crossover. Place your thumb on D. All right, now we're gonna stretch up to B flat so we can finish this song, finally. Here we come. Home stretch. Go up to B flat with your pinky. Play it twice. Next door, A, with the next finger, right, touching it, and then skip to F. Do that in a row. B flat, A, F, okay? Go up now and go down. That's it. That's the end of the song. Right at the end when you went up and down. Do this again. B flat twice. A is right next door. Skip to the F. Go up and down. That is it. That's happy birthday. All right. Now let's do that whole thing again. Just for good measure, to make sure you have it. C, C, high C, backwards F walking down, cross over, and then untuck your thumb to D. The B flat, that B in the backyard, if you've seen my other videos. Twice on the B flat. Next door, coming down, skip to the F, go up, and down. All right. We're going to move on now to the left hand. We need an upside down F chord. Actually, this is technically called an inverted F. C, F, A, the arrangement of which note comes first. Being on the left, on the low side, is your pinky on C. Your second finger's on F. Your thumb is on A. You have to use these fingers because of how we're going to be switching between the F chord and the C chord. All right, so that pointer finger's on F. Now, we're going to need the middle finger when we play C chord, like this. C, E, G. Pinky, middle finger, thumb. Make sure you have this. Okay, now hit the C chord. And hopefully you are familiar with the C chord, so this isn't too hard for you. But you might not be familiar with switching to this particular inverted chord that we're going to use. So get your fingers ready. All right, notice the whole hand goes up and down when we play them, all the fingers together. Now I'm going to move my second finger down, that index finger, and my thumb up at the same exact time. We can't move them separately. I'm showing you separately what they're doing, but you need to try to move them together like this, like you see me doing. This way, it's just one thing for you to learn. In your brain, it's taken as one action. Move those muscles together. When you come back to C chord, make that one action. Make it all together. Don't let it be four actions that you have to memorize because there's four different finger movements. Let it just be the two actions. Coming up for F chord, and then for C chord, the middle finger, you're moving back down at the same time. This will make it more automatic and easily quick for you if you do it this way. You don't want to be struggling in this song. You want it to be easy and quick to change from one chord to the next. So the sound will ring through the right hand notes while it's holding down each of these chords. You can hold it, and at the last second, switch to the next chord. Up for F. All right, down for C. All at once, make sure it's one movement. I think you're ready now to go ahead and put two hands together. So I want you to get ready for that right hand thumb, C, C, then two hands together, right there. Then go up to the F. Now play two hands together on C chord. And now you're going to play C, C again. Hit the C chord again with the D, right there. That was when they go together. Now high G, or the pinky anyway, on G. Now F chord with the right hand F. So the F chord in the left hand matches the F in the right hand at that moment. All right? Now, let's go back to remembering the order. It's F chord, C chord, C chord, F chord. That's the first line. F, C, C, F. So let's start on the double C with your thumb. Play the F chord, then, okay, after the double C. Now play the F by itself and hit C chord with E. Now play double C. Now another C chord for birthday. Now pinky by itself in the right hand. Now F chord. There you go, that's where they go together. All right, now in the left hand, you need to know how to reach up to B flat. All right, it's going to be your thumb up on the black note, B flat. You have to push your hand back like this to reach it well and play the other fingers. To make a smooth transition from where you were with the F chord, notice this, you come back this way for the F chord, C, F, A. Now, when I slide to the back, I'm going to use my fourth finger on D, my second finger on F, my thumb on B flat. And I just move straight to the back of the board to be able to reach that smoothly. I don't want to twist my wrist, so that's why I'm sliding back like this. Ring finger, index finger, and thumb, D, F, B flat. I don't want to move up and down the keyboard if I don't have to. I want to use fingers that are already over the notes that I need. So now I need a C chord, and that's easy to come to because I was in position for it. I just had to drop different fingers. And back to the F chord. This has to be really easy, and it is easy if you keep your hand in the right position. Watch this. I played my F chord like I already know. I slide backward for the new B flat chord, but I did not have to turn or twist my wrist. I come back to the front of the piano for another F chord, and then I move to C chord, and then I go back to the F chord. That is the left hand for the second line. All right, so let's do that together now. Two C's, high C with F chord, walking back on the F chord, cross over and play B flat right now, and then the D by itself when I uncross. So that left hand B flat chord went with the crossover note. All right, let's do that again. C, C, up to high C. Up to high C, walking back on the F chord. Crossover while I play B flat, that new chord. Play the D by itself. Now I'm going to reach up and play B flat, which you already know, and then play F chord with the A, F by itself, and then a C chord when I go up, and an F chord when I come back home. That's the whole song. Congratulations, you made it all the way through. All right, let's do a little review. That end was just a quick C chord, F chord. You didn't have time to hold it. All right, now let's do that again. Line two for the two sentences we just learned. Happy, and then up to the high C, walking back on the F chord. And then we're gonna cross over with B flat. Uncross, play D by itself. And then happy is a B flat by itself in the right hand. Now F chord with A, F by itself, up to a G with a C chord, and right back to F chord. The right hand was doing that little up and down at the end, and the left hand was playing C chord, F chord during that time. Super, super, I'm so proud of you guys. Just four things to remember on closing here. Easy Home Piano Lessons adds a new class every week, so make sure to subscribe. Second thing is, don't forget, when it's someone's birthday, you need to play the happy birthday song. And if you're interested in sheet music, and no, I will not be using the one in Spanish. I don't know how that got in there. I'll send it to you in English. Not that it matters, the notes are all the same. So look on the site and right here for the PDF for you to be able to download or print. And last of all, I'm here to answer any questions that you have. Thank you for taking the class.